In the world of animals, you might be surprised to know that earthworms are surprisingly complex. Their bodies are streamlined with no appendages, an adaptation that allows them to plow through the soil. They have no eyes. They do not need them since they live underground. They do have light-sensitive cells scattered throughout their skin to detect light. Being able to respond to a stimulus is a characteristic of all living things. This is an example of a stimulus and a response. The earthworm detects the light, and light means danger to the earthworm. Its response is to try to get back to safety in the darkness. The way the earthworm goes back into the darkness is by digging down, which it is attempting to do by going through my fingers. You can see the digestive tract of the worm through its skin. It looks like a tube of dirt, which is exactly what it is. The earthworm takes in dirt through its mouth. In that dirt is bits of organic matter like dead leaves. The earthworm digests the leaves, then gets rid of the dirt and any other material it cannot digest through the other end of the digestive tract. Another thing that makes the earthworm complex is that it has a closed circulatory system. Organisms that are less complex than the earthworm do not have a circulatory system. That means they have no blood. Earthworms do have a closed circulatory system with 5 hearts. These hearts pump blood through the vessels that sends blood to the worm's tail end. Then there's another vessel that brings blood back to the head area. Let's check out these zigzag areas that go from light to dark. That's the circulatory system in progress. You'll see the blood pumping through the earthworm. Now let's see what happens when we put the earthworm in ice water. So once we add the ice water, the heart rate will slow down to about 10 beats per minute, and activity level will also drop. Because worms are cold-blooded organisms, they take on the temperature of their surroundings. When their body temperature decreases, their circulatory system slows down, and the worm goes into an energy conservation mode, kind of like hibernation. When placed in a cold environment, humans would not react the same way. Our response to a colder environment is to shiver. How cool was that? I bet you'll never look at an earthworm quite the same way.